Dear students, now we will see the next topic, that is working with NumPy arrays. And the first one is accessing individual elements using array indexing. You know that indexing begins from 0 and it goes up to the, you see, number of elements minus 1. Okay, that is the last subscript. Alright, because there are 4 elements, last subscript is going to be 3. Alright, this is now 2D array. This also has what? You see rows 0, 1 and column 0, 1, 2, 3. Okay, so these two arrays I have created and I have displayed the individual elements of the array. So I'll show you on the screen. Okay, so let us see on the screen. Now see here, this is, can you see, I have imported NumPy facility LST. Through list I have created AR. Okay, then print AR. So array is printed. Then print 0th element. 0th element is 17. You can see. Okay, second element 11. Third element 18. Now the subscript can be, you see, in reverse order also. Okay, so those I will show you in your book. Okay, so let me show. Here you can see these are the subscript. Minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4. Okay. Here subscripts are. Here rows minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4. And here they are going to be, you see, minus 1 and minus 2. Okay. Rows minus 1, minus 2. Columns minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4. Reverse subscript, okay, in the reverse subscripts in the reverse order. Okay, so using this you can see here. Now this is yours, you can see that is minus 4. Minus 4 is the, you see, that is the, which one, 17, that is first 0th element. Okay, and minus 1 is the last one, that is the third element. Can you see? Okay, then we come to the second, that is the 2D array. 2D array I have created using this nested list. Alright, then you see it displayed also. Now 0 element is 0th row 0th column is 17. Okay, 0th row 0th column is 17. Alright, then you see 1 means first row and second element. Okay, first row, this is first row, second element 0, 1, 2, second element is 28. Alright, then you see 1, 0. 10 means first row and 0th is 55. Alright, so you can see here. Then we come to the next. Minus 2, minus 3. Minus 2 row is which one? That is the, you see, which is, we call it 0th row. Okay, and third, that is the minus 3 element. Alright, so it is going to be 23. Means, you see, this one, you can see here, this is going to be minus 2, alright, and then, alright, minus 2 row, and in that minus 3, so minus 3 is going to be minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, so that is yours 23, can you see, this is 23, you can see here, this is minus 1, minus 2. So this row is minus 2 row. And in that, this is minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. So 23. Okay. So your answer is 23. Alright. Same way, minus 1, minus 4. Minus 1 is this row. Alright. Minus 1. So this row. And in that, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4. Okay. That means 55. Okay. Minus 1, minus 4. 55. Same way, this one, that is, this is an error. So, I will show you the correctly executed one. Just a minute, let me scroll it down. Okay. Now, you can see, minus 2, minus 4. Okay, minus 2 row. Minus 2 row is, you can see here, this one it is. Minus 2 is, again, we go, this is minus 1, this is minus 2. Alright, means first row. And in that, minus 4. Alright, so it is going to be minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4 means it is going to be 17. Okay, so this is 17. Alright, this is 17. Alright, now you can change the value of any element. 1, 3 elements value is changed to 67. 1, 3, you can see here, this one I will show. This is 1, this is 0 through, this is 1. 1, 3, 0, 1, 2, 3 means 27 is changed to, now you can see 67. It is to be made 67. You can see the array, changed array. Now this 27 in place of 27, it is 67. Same example is there in your book also. So you can see that. Now dear students, the way we have got the we have found the slices of other data types, same way we'll be finding array slices also. Okay, first of all 1D array slices. Okay, so you can see here definition. You see, array slicing refers to the process of extracting a subset of elements from an existing array and returning the result as another array, possibly in a different dimension from the original. Okay, now because it's a slice, same direction will not be there, only few elements will be picked up as slice. Okay, or whole of the array also sometimes. Okay, now you see, this is the syntax: array name, start, stop, step. Okay, this is familiar. Okay, you are familiar with it. Okay, then you can see here, start is by default, start is 0, stop is dimension size, means we take, you see, dimension size minus 1 as the stop value then. Okay, and then because we go up to minus 1, all right, and then step is 1. This is by default. Okay, now this is the, you see, this is your this one, that is the array which we are going to refer to. Alright, first one is, that is 3:7. Start value is 3, okay, and start value will be 6, 1 less than 7. Okay, so the whatever is extracted is your 8, 10, 12, 14. Okay, you can see the this one, that is arrays negative, and you see 0 to 7 indices I have marked. Okay, then second one is ar:5, means start is 0. And stop will be 5 minus 1 is 4th index. Okay, then third one is ar:4, alright, and then you see it has to go from 4th to dimension size. What is the dimension size? Dimension size is 8, alright, so it will go up to 7. Dimension size minus 1 index, okay, I have written dimension size minus 1 index, okay, that is 7 it will go to, alright, so that's why it has gone from 10 to 16, alright. Now next is 0 to, you see, minus 1, minus 1 less than minus 1, 1 less than minus 1 is minus 2, so it will go from 0 to minus 2 index, okay, so minus 2 index is 14, alright. So it will go from 2 to 14, alright. Then here it comes to, you can see here, 0 to minus 2. Minus 2 minus 1 is minus 3. Okay, so it will go up to 0 to minus 3 index. It will go up to 0 to minus 3 index. Okay, so 0 to minus 3, I have marked everything, all the negative and positive indices, you can see. Once again, I will show you on the screen also. Then it is 0 to minus 3, means 0 to minus 3 minus 1 is minus 4. Okay, so 0 to minus 4 index. Alright, then 2 is the start value, 7 minus 1 is the, you see, up to there it will go, and step is 2. 7 minus 1 is 6. Okay, so 0 to 6, you can see, 2 to, it will be 2 to, you can see, 4, that is, it is starting from second index, so second index is 6. It will start from 6, it will go up to, you see, 6, 6th index, that is 14, and step is 2. Alright, so this is it. Now I will show it on the screen also. Once you can see here, this is first one, array is created, numpy is imported, array is created, 3:7. So you can see here, this is the output. Okay, then 0 to 5 minus 1, that is 4, that is, this is it. Okay, 4:2, dimension size minus 1, alright. Then you see 0 to You see, minus 1 minus 1 is, it is minus 2, up to minus 2 it will go, okay. Then 0 to minus 2 minus 1 is minus 3, up to minus 3 it will go. Alright, then 0 to minus 3 minus 3 minus 1 is minus 4, so up to minus 4 it will go, 0 to minus 4, okay. Then this is, start is 2, end is 7, 7 minus 1 is 6th, okay. So second, you see, that is second index to sixth index you are going to pick up, alright, second index to sixth index, and then step is 2, but step is also 2, okay. So this is it. Now dear students, array slicing of 2D array, you see here, but 2D means little bit complicated. We will have, you see, two sets of start, stop and step values. First set is for row and second set is for column, as it is told, okay. So it is going to be little more, you see, complicated, but it is quite interesting, okay. Now you see here, it is, one note is there, negative step value means reversed order of elements, okay. So anyway, we will see if we get any negative step value. Now here you see 2D array slice is computed as, first of all, extract row as per slice details or slice specified, and then, okay, for those extracted rows only we are supposed to apply column slices, you see, whatever is specified, okay. So you have to do in these two steps. These are very important. Now this is the array. I too have created this array. Alright, I will show you. Same array is created. I will show you this array creation. You can see here, this is array created by me. Alright, same array is created here. Alright, now we will see the examples. Then after that, I will show you each example, okay, on the screen. You see the first example. You can see here, is 2, 3. Means, start value is 0. Stop value, start value is 0. Okay, stop value is 3. Okay, step is not mentioned, by default it is 1. Okay, this is for row. Are you getting it? Stop value is 3, means it will go, row index will be 0 to 2. Row index will be 0 to 2 and step is 1. Are you getting it? So 0 to 2 means how many rows will be considered? You can see here, 0 to 2 means how many rows will be considered? Can you see? Only these rows will be considered, okay. 0 to 2, only 3 rows will be considered, okay. Once again, we will now see the, that is next one, that is now for that is the column. For column, you can see 3 is to, you see, nothing. So you can see for column 3 is the start value. Stop value is 5, because the dimension size is what? 5 columns are there. Can you see 5 columns? Okay, so dimension size is 5. Alright, and step is 1, means it will, stop will be 5 minus 1. Stop will be 5 minus 1. Means, you see, row, this column will be third column and greater, okay, greater than 3 columns. And stop value will be 1 less than 5, okay. So that means 3 to, you see, 4 columns will be only 3 to 4 columns. You can see here, only 3 to 4 is considered, okay. So as per row index and as per column index, I showed you that only 0, 1, 2 rows will be considered, and column 3 and 4 only. So this part is gray, okay, it is shown. So this one I will also show you on the screen. This one by one, each I will show executed one. So same thing, you can see here, the first one, okay, the same values are there, okay, that is 8, 10, then 18, 20, 28, 30, okay. Now next one, now I will show you, that is second example 2. Now you can see here, 1 is 2 means 1 is the start value, stop value is dimension of the row 4 minus 1. Dimension of the row is 4 minus 1. It will go, means it will go from 1 to, you see, that is 1 to 3. It will go up to 1 to 3. But step is 2, means 1 and 3.
Can you see these three? 1 and 3 rows. Okay, this. Alright. Then for column, column what is given is 2, 3. Means for column start value is 0. It is not mentioned in 0. Stop value is given 3. Step is not given. Okay, means step will be what? 1. Step will be 1. Okay, so start value 0 and stop value will be 3. So you can see here, start value is 0 and stop value is 3. Okay, so you can see this is the output. Okay, now you can see here, this is column will go from 0 to 3, stop value means 1 less, means up to 2. Okay, so this is, you see, yours output. Okay, I'll show you, that will be your output is going to be 12 14 16. All right so this will not be there, this will not be there, this thing will not be there. All right this will not be there. 12 14, you can see this, these two will not be there in the output. 12 14 16 and 32 34 36. I will show you this one. That is 1:2:2. This one. Okay. So I am showing this output. You can see here. This is. Okay. 12, 14, 16. Then 32, 34, 36. Okay. This, you see, this one. This is great. Please make it. You see, just remove this grayish part and just. Don't consider this grayish part. Now this is going to be the only gray part is going to be the output. Okay, now, okay, here it is also shown, this output is shown, that also I showed you. Okay, so this is it. Now we will see the next one, that is here you can see AR wise, you see is 2 is 2 3, means the step is 3. Okay, start value 0, stop value 4. 4 is the dimension of the row. Okay, so 4, stop value will be 4, means 4 minus 1, 3 we will consider, and step is also 3, means 0 to 3. So 0 to 3, 0 to 3. Okay, and step is 3, means 0th and 3rd row will be considered. Okay, these two rows will be considered. Alright, but what about column? Column is given is 2 is 2 2, means what? The start value is 0, stop value is 5, because the dimension of the column is 5. Okay, 5 is the size. Okay, minus 1 means 4. All right and step is 2. Minus 1 means 4, means 0 to 4 all the columns, but step is 2, that's why 0 2 4. Okay, these two rows we were supposed to consider. These two rows we were supposed to consider because step was 3. Alright. And then you see column step is also 2. That's why alternate 2, 6, 10. Alright. And here 32, 36, 40. Okay. This output I will show you. Okay. This is it. Okay. Alright. Then we come to the next one. Alright. Next one. Let us see this one. Example is yours 4. Minus 3 minus 1. Alright, minus 3 is 2 minus 1. Okay, now see here, this one start value is minus 3, stop value is minus 1. Okay, so it will be minus 1 minus 1 will be minus 2. Okay, and step is 1. So start value is minus 3. Alright. And stop value is, start value is minus 3 and stop value is, you see, that is minus 3, minus 1 will be minus 2. Okay, so minus 3 to minus 2. Alright, so you can see these two rows, minus 3 to minus 2, these two rows. Okay, these two rows. But let us see what is the column, you see, that is the dimensions, column slicing for that, what is specifications. So it is minus 5, okay, is to 2. Minus 5 is the start value. All right and stop value is not given, means the dimension is what? Dimension is 5 minus 1 is 4, stop value is 4, okay, and then you see step is 2, alright. So we will start from, you see, minus 5, start will be minus 5, okay, and stop will be, what is that, 4, okay. So 4 comes where, 4 is this one, last one, alright, 4 is this one, can you see, last column, so it will go up to here. But step is given. Step is what? 2. So 2. Okay. So these two rows, why we considered, I explained. And now columns, since step columns also, this minus 5, 2, it will go up to 4 because stop value is not given. Okay. So it will go up to 4. 4 means dimension minus 1, 5 is the dimension minus 1, 4. Okay. And then step is 2, that's why this one. Okay. So this is it. Now I'll show you the output, till then you watch, you keep seeing this one. All right, now I'll show you this output. Okay, now you can see here, this is the output. Okay, dear students, now next topic, 314 page, joining or concatenating numpy arrays. Within that, first topic is combining existing arrays horizontally or vertically. But actually we are not combining, we are using H stack and V stack function, and we will be creating arrays. Okay, horizontally merging is this, both will get merged horizontally, and we will see this, it will become one array. Alright, vertically means they will get merged, okay, this way vertically, alright. And then you see these two arrays will get vertically merged, alright. This is called vertical merging. For that we will be using H stack function, and we will be using V stack function. Okay, so I'll show you, this is the example in your book, I'll show you on the screen, same example you can see here. This is, I have created four lists, can you see, with different and that is number of elements, and you see one is last two are nested lists. Okay, now you see imported numpy facility V stack, and I have merged that is this one LST1 and LST2, and I have formed SR1. Alright, so you can see here V means vertically merging. Okay, so these two LST1 LST2 got merged. Alright, then we come to this one, that is again vertically merging LST2 and LST3. Alright, so can you see LST2 and LST3. Alright, and I have formed ASR2, so ASR2 is this, okay, merging this one. You can see LST2 is this, and LST3 has got nested list, okay, two rows are there. So altogether it becomes three rows. Alright, then it comes to SAR3 is formed by horizontally merging LST3 and LST4. LST3 and LST4, I will show you. This is LST3, LST4. Okay, so you can see here. Now, by that, we have, you see, merged LST3 and LST4 and found, you see, this SAR3. Alright, this is by horizontally merging, okay. So this way you can see here, it is horizontally merged. 4 and 5 becomes the fourth column in SAR3, alright, horizontally merged. Then we come to the next, that is 2D array. You see, 2D array, R1 is created, alright. This 2D arrays, we will see, that is horizontally and vertically merging, okay. So let me show you, that is, I will scroll the screen and I will show you. So you can see, AR1, can you see, it has got three rows, three columns. AR2, it has got also three rows, three columns. Vertically merged, can you see, this array vertically merged. So 6 rows, it becomes 6 rows, but columns remain the same. Horizontally merged, 6 columns, rows remain the same. Okay, AR4 is, you see, it is formed by horizontally merging AR1 and AR2.
This is vertically merging AR1 and AR2. See the outputs, you will find the difference. Okay, alright. Now we come to the next. That is, now we will be finding this one. That is, I have created array AR1. Can you see? This is AR1 created with 3. You see a list which has got 3 nested list. Then this has got 2 nested list. This has got again 3 nested list. This also, okay. So AR1, AR2, AR3, AR4 created. Okay. This part I'll first explain you in the book, in your book. Okay. How this 4 of the arrays will be concatenated. Okay. Now next function is concatenation function. Concatenation function I'll show you in your book. You can see here, concatenation function. Okay. Okay. Combining existing arrays using concatenate. Okay. Concatenate function with this syntax. Can you see this syntax? Okay. So you can see here, this, they will be here. You see, concatenated arrays will be concatenated. Okay, so now let us see here. These are 4 arrays which I have created. I showed you AR1, AR2, AR3, AR4, and AR5. Okay, 5 arrays rather. Okay, 5 arrays I have created. So those 5 arrays I'll show you once again. Alright, using these 5 arrays, now we are combining, we are concatenating, okay, we are using concatenation function and concatenating arrays, okay. First one, you see, concatenating AR1 and AR2. AR1 has got 3 elements and AR2 also has got 3 elements. I'll show you, AR1 has got 3 elements, AR2 has got 3 elements. So, both can be vertically merged. When they are merged vertically, so axis becomes 0 vertically, where number of columns are same. Vertically concatenation, alright, and axis becomes 0. Alright, second one, merging AR1 and AR3. I'll show you which is AR1 and AR3. AR1 has got 3 columns, but AR3 has got only 2 columns. Can you see? So here, when they are merging, they cannot be merged vertically. So they are merged how? Horizontally. Okay. When they are merged horizontally, so this way, you see, the 2 arrays are merged horizontally. This is horizontal merging. Alright. And this is the resultant array. This is shown by this diagram also. Horizontal merging. Axis becomes 1. Alright. Then, concatenating AR1 and AR4. AR1 and AR4, I'll show you. AR1 is this and AR4 this one. AR1 has got 3 columns, AR4 has got only 1 column. Vertical merging is not possible, so it will be horizontal merging. And horizontally merging, you see, that is along the axis 1. Horizontally merging along axis 1. Axis 1 is this axis, okay. And these are the elements of AR4. These are the elements of AR1. Alright. Then again it comes to, you see, merging AR2 and AR1. You know, AR2 and AR1 both have got same number of columns. That's why they can be merged here very well. AR2 and AR1, okay, vertically and along 0th axis. 0th axis means this axis. Okay, 0th axis. You see, first 2 rows are of AR2 and last 3 rows are of AR1. Alright, then it comes to example 5, that is merging AR2 getting concatenated with AR5. AR2 getting concatenated with AR5. Let me see, AR2, that is, it has got 3 columns, okay, and AR5 has got 4 columns. So it's not possible to merge vertically, that's why it is along axis 1. Alright, and these 3 are of, these 3 columns are of AR2 and these 4 columns are of AR5. That is, you see, horizontally merging. This is horizontally merging, okay. Then we come to the next example, number 6. Alright, now
Example number 6 has got little variation. AR1 and AR2 are directly not concatenated, not merged. What there when AR2's transposed array is, you see, concatenated. Transposing, you just see, this is AR2, 242 and 191. This is first row, this is second row, alright? But when it is transposed, so this columns becomes row, 21. 49 column becomes 49 row, and 21 column becomes, you see, 21 row. So now transposed array of AR2 has got 3 rows and 2 columns, okay? So when it is merging with AR1, AR1 has got these 3 rows, okay? These 3 pink colored rows are of AR1, and AR2 now transposed has got only 2 columns, okay? AR1 has got 3 columns, AR2 has got only 2 columns. So you see, vertical merging is not possible, concatenation is not possible. So it is along axis 1, okay? This is along axis 1 and horizontally merging. This is 6th example. 7th example, if you give, you see, axis as none, then simply, you see, concatenation is, all the data is in the form of 1, that is 1D array, simple, alright, if axis is none, alright. So this is, you see, this one. Now I'll show these all practically. You see, first of all I'll show you, see, I have created these 5 arrays. I'll just show you all 5 array created, and then all 7 examples I will show. Okay, all 5 arrays created, R1, R2, R3, R4, R4 shown also, R5. These 5 arrays are created. Then GR1, that is first example, concatenation of AR1 and AR2. Okay, since you see both have got same number of elements, that's why merging is on the basis of 0th axis, alright, and then vertically merged or concatenated. Okay, then GR2, second example. Okay, AR1 and AR3 hasn't got the, you see, these, that is same number of elements as AR1. AR3 has got two columns. Okay, AR3 has got 2 columns and AR1 has got 3 columns, so it cannot be merged vertically. That's why horizontally merged, okay, along axis 1. Alright, then JAR3 is formed by concatenation of AR1 and AR4. AR1 has got 3 columns, AR4 has got only 1 column. AR4 has got only 1 column. So vertical merging is not possible, that's why merged or concatenated horizontally along axis 1. Alright, then JAR4. Concatenation of AR2 and AR1. AR2 has got 3 columns and AR1 has got, you see, also 3 columns. Alright, so that's why vertical merging is very much possible. Alright, so vertically concatenated. Okay, vertically concatenated along 0th axis. Alright, then next is, you see, JAR5. Concatenation of AR2 and AR5. AR5 has got 5, AR5 has got 4 columns, AR2 has got 3 columns. So vertically merging or concatenation is not possible, that's why horizontally merged. Okay, horizontally merged. Alright, following it, AR2's first 3 columns are of AR2 and you see these 4 columns are of AR5. So this way, you see, horizontally merged along axis 1. Then comes JAR6. Okay, concatenation of AR1 and AR2, and AR2 is transposed. AR2 transposed, I already told you. AR2 has got, I have already told you, AR2 has got 3, I'll just show, 3, I'll show you. This is, AR2 has got 3 columns and 2 rows. But when it is transposed, it becomes, you see, 3 rows. It becomes 3 rows and 2 columns. So that's why, you see, this one is not possible. This one's this transpose here in transposed AR2
vertical merging is not possible, so it is merged horizontally or concatenated horizontally along axis 1. Then comes AR7, we have given axis none, so simply you see all the data is arranged in the form of 1D array, okay.